So here's a quiz for you. Although accuracy is a perfectly fine metric and a good place to start, it does have some shortcomings. So let's think about what those might be in the case where we want to identify persons of interest in the Enron data set. So here are a few possible shortcomings, and you check all of the ones that sound like they could be problems in our case. The first possible problem is that maybe accuracy is not ideal for skewed classes. So a skewed class would be an example of where you have many data points and a few of them fall into one class and many of them fall into the other class. This is what's going on with the Enron dataset, because although there were thousands of people who worked at Enron, there were only a few dozen who ended up really being pursued by the law for their involvement in the fraud. So accuracy might not be an ideal metric in that particular case where you have very few examples of one of the classes. Another possibility is that maybe depending on exactly what you mean by identifying a person of interest, you might want to err on the side of guessing that someone is innocent when you're in doubt. That if, for example, as a result of this, that maybe your machine learning algorithm is identifying people who should be thrown in jail. In that case, I would say you want to be really sure that someone is involved in the fraud before you risk putting them in jail for a long time. And that if you have any doubt at all, you should err on the side of assuming that they're innocent. That accuracy perhaps might be not particularly tailored to that outcome that you want. And a third possibility might be that accuracy isn't well tailored to the outcome that you want, but in the other direction. Let's suppose that you want kind of a broad net being cast. That all the people who are identified as persons of interest just means that they're going to get a little bit of a higher level of scrutiny. And that there might be still lots of investigation going on. And so in that case, what you would want to do is make sure that you get as many people who were actually involved in the fraud as possible identified, even if it comes to the cost of identifying some people who were probably innocent, because those innocent people will then be investigated and cleared in later rounds of the investigation. And that accuracy might not be the right metric if that's the goal that you're going for in trying to identify persons of interest. So check any of these boxes that you think could be a little bit of a problem if all you're doing is trying to maximize the accuracy of your classifier.